Though many IT organizations have been stressing on green efforts over the past decade, the initiative seems to be gaining more attention than ever due to the fact that IT operational costs seem to be increasing at an alarming rate. Typically, the term green was used as a business gimmick to attract more customers in the past. Now, over the years, issues such as increase in cost of electricity and climate change have placed organizations in a mandatory position to take upon real green efforts rather than simply greenwashing. As new trends such as big data clusters, cloud computing, virtualization, and etc. come into the picture, the requirement for a green data center framework is required to achieve significant green standards. Metrics and measurements is a key component of a green data center framework. Greenhouse gas, or GHG, is a subset of this metric, and it is extremely vital that the measurement of GHG to be aligned with the Malaysian government's pledge to reduce the GHG emission intensity to 40% by the year 2020 compared to 2005 levels. Hence, organizations must declare the greenhouse gas reduction target. As of now, the de facto measurement tool for data centers is the power utilization effectiveness, PUE, which is the ratio of total facility load to total IT load. Ideally, a PUE value of 2 means that for every watt used to power IT equipment, an additional watt is required to keep the equipment cool. Now, data center managers are increasingly working to take measures to reduce PUE. The PUE metric was introduced by the Green Grid Organization, an association of IT professionals focused on increasing the energy efficiency of data centers. A PUE value of 1 portrays the optimal level of data center efficiency. In practical terms, a value of 1 general means that all power supplying into the data center is being used to power the IT equipment. Now, cooling is added into this equation to cool the IT load, which is needed to support the environment. At Basis Bay, our environment is tightly controlled and monitored to achieve a PUE in the range of 1.4 to 1.6 by optimizing its power and cooling methodology over a period of time. This, in return, will benefit the customers. Traditionally, the IT and facility team work and operate in separate silos, where the CFOs are directly involved in the IT budget, but not on the utility costs consumed by these machines. The FM folks could be over-provisioning power and cooling without concurring with the IT team to what is required, and here arises a disconnect between both teams. After this transformation, i.e. combining both IT and FM under the purview of the CFO, excessive spending can be avoided and dollars saved by achieving a common goal to be sustainable. Now, it is a unique combination which makes dollars and cents, and Basis Bay is the only organization in this region, for that matter, to exhibit this value proposition. In addition to that, several key design factors need to be taken into consideration to achieve green data center standards. Now, some of these can be divided into three categories, namely the business requirement, site selection criteria, where we are looking at natural disasters and away from certain environment, maybe industries that are critical to the data center, and also the physical design comprising mechanical and electrical aspect of it. Some of the green initiatives we have considered during the M&E physical aspect of it will be the orientation of the building. The building orientation emphasizes the direction of the sun in such a way direct exposure of the walls to the sun is reduced. The wall and glass finishes of the building faces the sun at an angle where direct contact is minimized. This practice enables reduction in natural heating permitting through the glass into the building interiors, thereby reducing the demand for high cooling consumption. Next will be wall insulation and thickness. Double gray brick cavity walls fortified with rock wool insulation in between 18 mm thick plaster and 15 mm insulation paint render the building almost impenetrable to heat. This has enabled our green data center to achieve a 2-hour fire resistant rating. Bathtub roof, which is actually on the roof of our building. High walls reduce direct heat from the sun. Shrubs and plants provide a natural cool shade on the roof in the afternoon, while floors have a double layer concrete screed with waterproofing membrane to prevent water leaks and enhance heat resistance. Tinted and laminated glassworks tinted with emerald green allows building to provide a soothing natural light while reducing discharge heat into the common areas. For security and safety measures, laminated glass is used in all critical areas of the building. A ducted fresh air system. Natural ventilation to all the common corridors is achieved through a ducted fresh air fan intake system, inducing natural airflow throughout the building. Now this actually enhances the indoor air quality. Smart lights. Throughout the building, energy efficient lights are used. Occupancy sensors and photo sensors are deployed to minimize energy. This is coupled with photo sensors control lights located closer to windows, which turns on when natural light is too low. All common lights are controlled individually to provide flexibility of use. Photovoltaic panels. The harnessing of solar is taken further by using photovoltaic panels to reduce cost of power and to enhance energy efficiency. This is achieved by using solar panels to generate power, which is fed back into the national grid. A data center operating elements consist of strictly adhering to standard industrial best practices, such as hot, cold aisle configuration, containment, computational fluid dynamics analysis, and etc. Now, the key component of a green data center will be continuous monitoring and improvement by implementing data center infrastructure management or DCIM tools. DCIM can play an imperative role to help organizations manage their facility more effectively and efficiently in terms of power, cooling, manpower allocation. Now, at present, most data centers, at least in the South Asia region, only deploy tools to monitor the environment, which is the basic subset of any DCIM package. At most, operators will be able to control some of the systems, mainly the heating, ventilation, and air conditioning system. Now, the saying, you can't manage if you don't measure. Hence, the key aspect of operating any data center is to keep track of pertinent parameters, such as power consumption at various levels. This is no significance to the PU value if no measures are put in place to further optimize the environment to achieve a better PU. This is where DCIM tools can be put in place dynamically, control the environment with little or no human intervention. Hence, full automation is required. Now, the idea of a continuous availability and clouds of dynamic on-demand services have data center operators running their facility at near maximum capacity regardless of demand. Now, the vast amount of energy is wasted to the environment in heat form, which needs to be extracted, consuming even more energy. The recent advancement of DCIM tools has allowed operators to monitor power consumption at server level for each transaction made by the server. This can allow for proper prediction of the exact power needed in actual rather than operating at near maximum capacities, which can directly reduce losses in terms of heat and cooling. Uses of commercial computational fluid dynamic, or CFD for short, software to optimize computer room performance has become a thing of the past. Conventionally, the simulation is carried out based on the future predicted load at the design stage. This would lead to the oversizing of crack units, whereby the actual IT load will be much lower in day one. In typical scenario, it will take almost a year till the IT load reaches the actual forecasted value. This will directly result in the computer room being overcooled, since day one. The current capability of DCIM software to dynamically control the crack cooling load based on real-time power monitoring of the IT server racks can help provide tremendous savings in terms of operational costs. Sensors deployed strategically at various locations within the computer room can help identify possible hotspots and directly control specific crack units to eliminate the problem.